students. Already you learned closure property and commutative property in rational numbers under four fundamental operations. Today we are going to learn some more properties. The third property is associative property. What is an associative property? Take any three rational numbers. If you add, subtract, multiply or divide in any order, if the result is same, then we say that rational numbers follow associative property under these four operations. Now let us check first under addition. Now take three rational numbers here. 3/8 plus 5/4 plus 1/2 and 3/8 plus 5/4 plus 1/2. The sum of 3/8 and 5/4 is added to 1/2 here. And here 3/8 is added to the sum of 5/4 and 1/2. Now let us check the sum in both cases. Now the first one, we have to add the fractions first within brackets. Now here 3/8 and 5/4 are unlike fractions. So we have to convert into like fractions and we have to add. So what is the LCM of denominators here? LCM of 8 and 4 is 8, because 4 is the factor of 8, greatest number is the LCM. Now here we are converting these unlike fractions into like fractions with this 8 as a denominator. Now you take some number upon by 8 plus some number upon by 8. Now 8 times 1 is 8, with that 1 we are multiplying 3, 1 3s are 3. 4 times 2 is 8 and 2 is multiplied by 5, 2 5s are 10 plus 1/2. Now these two are like fractions. 3 plus 10, 13/8 plus 1/2. Now again the LCM of 8 and 2 is 8. So we are converting these two unlike fractions into like fractions. LCM of 8 and 2 is 8. So we are converting these two unlike fractions into like fractions with 8 as a denominator. So some number upon 8 here plus some number upon 8. 8 times 1 is 8. So 1 is multiplied by 13. 1 13s are 13. 2 times 4 is 8. 4 is multiplied by 1. 4 1s are 4. Now 13 plus 4, 17/8. This is the answer for left LHS. Now come to the right side one. 3/8 plus, since these two are unlike fractions, find the LCM of denominators. LCM of 4 and 2 is 4, because 2 is the factor of 4, greatest number is the LCM. Now we are converting these two unlike fractions into like fractions with 4 as a denominator. Now some number upon by 4 plus some number upon by 4. 4 times 1 is 4, so 1 is multiplied by 5, 1 5s are 5. Now 2 times 2 is 4 and 2 is multiplied by 1, 2 1s are 2. Now 3/8 plus, these two are like fractions, so add numerators, 5 plus 2, 7/4. Now again, what is LCM of 8 and 4 here? Again, both are unlike fractions, we have to convert into like fractions and add. 8 and 4 LCM is 8. Now some number upon by 8 plus some number upon by 8. Now 8 times 1 is 8. 1 is multiplied by 3. 1 3s are 3. 4 times 2 is 8. 2 is multiplied by 7. 2 7s 14. Now 3 plus 14, 17/8. Now you see the sum in both cases. Does it same? Yes. It means that rational numbers follow associative property under addition. In general, we say for any three rational numbers A, B and C, A plus B plus C is equal to A plus B plus C. Now come to subtraction. Here we have like fractions. Now 8/4 minus 6/4 minus 1/4, 8/4 minus 6/4 minus 1/4. From the difference of 8/4 and 6/4, we are subtracting 1/4 here. From 8/4, we are subtracting the difference of 6/4 and 1/4. Now let us check the difference in both cases. Now since these two are like fractions, subtract the numerators. 8 minus 6, 2/4 minus 1/4. Again, these two are like fractions. So subtract the numerators 2 minus 1, 1 by 4. Now here you see 8 by 4 minus, since these two are like fractions, 6 minus 1 is 5, 5 by 4. Again, like fractions, 8 minus 5, 3 by 4. Does it same here difference? No. It means that rational numbers does not follow associative property under subtraction. So, in general we say, for any three rational numbers A, B and C, A minus B minus C is not equal to A minus B minus C. Now come to multiplication. Now again I took three rational numbers here. Let us multiply in different order. First we are multiplying the product of 2 by 3 and 4 by 10. And that product is multiplied by this. Now simplify here the fractions first within brackets. 2 ones, 2 fives. Now further we can't simplify. 1 fours are 4 and 3 fives are 15. Into 15 by 12. Now here 4 ones, 4 threes, 15 ones, 15 ones. 1 ones are 1 and 1 threes are 3. So here left side part is 1 by 3. Now let us check the right side one. Take 2 by 3 here into. Now find simplify the fractions first within brackets. 4 ones, 4 threes and 5 threes and 5 twos. Again 3 ones, 3 ones. 1 ones are 1 and 2 ones are 2. Cancel 2 and 2 here and finally we got 3, 1 by 3. Is 1 by 3 is equal to 1 by 3? Yes. It means that rational numbers follow associative property under multiplication. So in general we say that for any three rational numbers A, B and C, A into B into C is equal to A into B into C. Now finally let us check under division. Now 8 divided by 4, this quotient is divided by 2 and 8 divided by the quotient of 4 divided by 2. 8 divided by 4 means 4 twos are 8, divided by 2, 2 divided by 2 means 1. Now 8 divided by 4 divided by 2 means 2 twos are 4. Now 8 divided by 2 means 2 fours are 8, which is 4. Is 1 and 4 are equal? No, they are not equal. It means that rational numbers does not follow associative property under division. In general, we can say that for any three rational numbers A, B and C, A divided by B divided by C is not equal to A divided by B divided by C. So from this, we can conclude that rational numbers follow associative property only under addition and multiplication, but not under subtraction and division. Now come to some additional properties here. Now you see here role of a zero, or we can say it is a zero property. Now when we add zero to any number, whether it may be natural number or whole number or integer or rational number, the result is same. Now let us see one example here. 3 by 5 plus 0 is equal to 3 by 5 and 0 plus 3 by 5 is equal to 3 by 5. Now here 0 is not affecting the result. We are getting the same number. Means any rational number is added to 0 or 0 is added to any rational number, we get the rational number itself. From this we can say that 0 is called additive identity. In general we say that for any rational number A, A plus 0 is equal to 0 plus A is equal to A. Now come to the additive inverse. Now if you take any rational number and if you add its additive inverse, additive inverse is nothing but just you change the sign of the given rational number. First one is positive, so we changed its additive inverse as into negative. Now here minus 4 by 7 if you take, its additive inverse is 4 by 7. The sum of a rational number and its additive inverse always 0. So in general we say that for any rational number A, A plus minus A is equal to minus A plus A is equal to 0. Now role of 1. 1 is also a special number. Earlier we saw addition. Now let us see multiplication here. For example, 7 by 10 into 1 is equal to 7 by 10. 1 into 7 by 10 is equal to 7 by 10. Here, product does not change. Multiplying any number by 1, it does not affect. We get the same number. So if any rational number is multiplied by 1 or 1 is multiplied by any rational number, we get rational number itself. Now here, 1 is called multiplicative identity. In general, we say for any rational number A, A into 1 is equal to 1 into A is equal to A. Now come to the inverse, multiplicative inverse. Now take a rational number 8 by 15. Now multiply this rational number with its multiplicative inverse. Multiplicative inverse is nothing but its reciprocal. Means we are interchanging the numerator and denominator of the fraction, that is 15 by 8. If you take 15 by 8, its reciprocal is 8 by 15. So the product of a rational number and its reciprocal always gives the value 1. So in general, we say that for any rational number A, A into 1 by A is equal to 1 by A into A is equal to 1.